Hi friends, I would like to share with you today different methods in how to secure your wig. There are many videos out there with really great information. That's how I learned. So I'd like just to show you today what I have tried and what works best for me and why. So this is double-sided wig tape. This is It Stays Body Adhesive. It is a glue with a roller ball. You store it upside down so this stays wet and it goes on easier. But make sure you put the lid on good and tight because it leaks. I found out the hard way and it's a sticky mess. And then got to be glued hair gel in the black tube because this dries clear. I believe the one in the yellow tube does not dry completely clear like this one does. So those are the three adhesives that I have tried. Now there is the stocking cap. It's just like the old-fashioned knee-high pantyhose we used to wear. There's also a fishnet one that works really great for long hair. This has a hole at the top so that all your hair can go up into there and then you fasten it down. This is a hair topper. It is just like a partial wig. It's what I started with when I was just experimenting and learning. It worked at the time. The problem for me is that it has these little clips on the side that clip into your hair, and there's one at the back. But where the clips were, it goes right where I don't have any hair. So I couldn't clip it. I had nothing to clip it to. So I took the clips off. I use double stick tape, the wig tape, and then the back clip. So you just cut off a little piece of this wig tape. You put it on the front. There's a little silicone strip there. You stick the wig tape to that. Take the backing off. And then put it right at your hairline. And hook the back clip. In my opinion, the wig tape is good for little pieces like this or really short, light wigs. Of course, this isn't going to blend so great because my hair is pulled back. But it holds. It holds it quite well through the day because it is lightweight. I've tried this with full wigs that are maybe a little bit longer, and it just doesn't feel as secure to me. So I worry too much about it, like, is my wig going to fall off or get twisted or whatever? So, and then it comes off quite easily as well. And so that is my experience with the topper and the glue. I'm sorry, and the tape. It worked for me in the beginning, but for me to wear a topper, I have to shampoo, blow dry, style my natural hair, and then put this on. Whereas when I wear a wig, I just pull my hair back in a ponytail and put the wig on and I'm good to go. There's no bad hair day when you're wearing a wig. So I don't have to mess with my own hair at all. So that is why I stopped wearing this topper. I still wear it once in a while, but not very often. And then there is the stocking cap. If you have real long hair, you can do like French braids and then overlap them or whatever it takes to get your hair flat to your scalp. And then you put this cap over. You can use It Stays or Got to be Glued or even hair tape if that's what works for you. If you're wearing a short, lightweight wig, you could use the wig tape. But I prefer the It Stays it works better for me. You put it underneath, you put the cap down, and maybe a little bit on top of that. And then you put your wig on over that. Let me show you. Oops. There. And this is my own personal wig. I wear this daily. This is Gabor's Premium in Buttered Biscuit. I have trimmed the bangs, razored the bangs. You go under the hair fiber, but on top of the wig cap, and you just press down where you put the glue. You don't want to get on top and push down because then all this gets glued down with it. So you go under and you hold it. Some people will put glue in the back as well to hold the nape in place, but I have a pretty significant scar back there from a cervical spine surgery I had, so I'm too sensitive back there to have it glued down. Maybe I will again someday, but for now, I don't. So anyway, it's all glued down, and it's good to go, but I don't like wearing the cap because it's just another layer. It's just more. It feels like you're wearing a hat underneath a hat all day long. And then even with it being glued down, maybe because I don't glue it in back, I don't know, but it does kind of scooch up to where it's like balled up underneath your wig. And to me, that's not secure or comfortable. I don't want to worry about my hair, my wig falling off or getting blown in the wind and coming off. So I don't wear the wig cap, but it's still very easy to come off with the, it stays. You just get a wet washcloth and you wet down everywhere that you have glue. And then it lifts off quite easily. And if there is an area that's stuck a little too well, you can take a wet Q-tip and roll it through there to get it to release. And then I take the wet washcloth and just dab it on the front of the wig and on the lace front so that it doesn't get all gummy and it keeps the lace clean. So this is the wig cap that I do not wear. This is what I do wear. This is a Wig Grip Headband. It has a little picture here that tells you how to wear it. It's really not complicated though. It has velvet loops that are kind of like Velcro, but really soft. And one side grips into your hair and keeps it in place. You Velcro the back. And then the top has loops that grip on to the top of the wig. So again, I have this in place. I use It Stays. I like this one best because I don't have to actually get my hands sticky. When you use this, you do have to kind of smash it in and get it where you need it, but I prefer not to have to touch my hands to it because then they get sticky and then you touch the hair, the fibers of the wig, and they get sticky, and I just would prefer not to touch it. So, and again, I pull this out of the side so that it blends with the hairline of the wig. So, and again, I am going to go under where I glued it, pressing it down And then I comb my hair with the wig at the hairline. And sometimes if I didn't get the glue far enough down, or I can put it on a Q-tip and kind of go in there. I'm not going to take it off and do it again. I don't want to that wear and tear on the lace front and on this wig in general. So again, at the end of the day, I take my wet wash rag, I wet it, wet the hairline, it lifts off, it releases, and then I just clean off the wig. Never rub or scrub. You just dab it on the lace to get it clean, to make sure it doesn't get gummy. So I will have all these products listed in the description below. What works for me, where I got them, and if you have any questions, reach out to me through my website, acompassionatehand.com. Thanks so much. See you next time.